Okay, so I want to take one more lesson just to look at some more interesting groups. Yesterday we looked at the integers mod n, and today I'm going to start with a very simple group. My group A is going to be the fourth roots of 1. In other words, it's the fourth roots of 1. And what are they? Well, that is just a set of 4 elements, 1, minus 1, the imaginary number I, and negative the imaginary number I. So take any one of those and multiply it by itself 4 times. 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 is 1. Negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1, that's 1. I times I is negative 1, and that squared is again 1. And negative I to the power 4, that's also going to be 1. And the binary operation is going to be multiplication. Multiplication. So let's just see if we have a group here consisting of A under multiplication. Is that a group or not? So let's just very quickly go to a Cayley's table. We have multiplication, we have 1, we have negative 1, we have I, and we have negative I. So on this side we must have 1, negative 1, we must have I, and negative I. There we go. See if you can do this. 1 times 1 is 1, negative 1, I, negative I. And same here, 1, I, negative I. So it seems as we already have an identity element. Let's just make sure and carry on with that. Negative 1 times negative 1 is 1. Negative 1 times I is negative I. And negative 1 times negative I, that's just going to be I. I times negative 1 is negative I. I times I is negative 1. And I times I is negative 1. With that negative gives me a 1. Negative I times 1 is negative I. That gives me an I. I times I is negative 1. And with this negative just gives me a 1. And I, negative and a negative is a positive. And I times I is negative 1. So we have negative 1 there. I hope I didn't make a tiny little error in my arithmetic there. So there's a Cayley's table. We seem to have an identity element. Our identity element of those is 1. And let's see if we have unique. If we have, there's also closure under multiplication, because the multiplication of any of the two of those just leaves me with one of the elements. So we have that. I'm going to leave the associativity property to you. You'll definitely see that that holds. But let's just look at inverse. What is the inverse? What is the inverse of each of these? Of 1 is, so what times 1 in this group will give me back the identity element? So 1 is its own inverse. Negative 1, what is its inverse? What times negative 1 gives me a 1 again? Well, it's its own inverse. I, what must I multiply I by to get 1? That's negative I. And negative I, its inverse is, negative I's inverse is I. So we see we have all of them there, 1, negative 1, negative I, and I. So they, each one is in there, and each one's inverse, and the other way around, is unique. So we do have that the fourth roots of 1 under the binary operation of multiplication is indeed a group. I'm going to clear the board. Let's look at one that's slightly more difficult. Here's our second example, which is going to be slightly more difficult. It is the third roots of 1. And we see there negative a half plus a half squared root of 3i, negative half minus a half squared root of 3i, and 1. And my binary operation is multiplication. So just take any one of these to the power 3, and of course you're going to get 1. Just to make things easier, we'll call this omega 1, we'll call this omega 2, and 1 we'll call omega 3. And under multiplication, here's my Cayley's table. Do this, it's nice mental exercises to do these multiplications, and we see this Cayley's table. Omega 1 times omega 1 gives me omega 2, and what we can very quickly see here is, of course, we have closure. I leave you with the associative property, but I'll tell you now that it does hold. And then let's just see if there's an inverse. What is the inverse? Let's see if those exist and are unique. Well, E just seems to be, my identity element is, of course, omega 3, which, you know, we can think is going to be 1. Anything times 1 here is going to be anything. So let's just look at the inverse of omega 1. So what times omega 1 gives me omega 3? So its inverse is, the inverse of omega 1 is omega 2. the inverse of omega 2 is, so 2 times what gives me omega 3? Omega 2 times omega 1, so omega 1 and omega 3, its inverse, the inverse of omega 3 is of course omega 3. Because if I multiply omega 3 by omega 3, I still get omega 3. And we see that these are unique as well. So my inverses, they are all in that set and each of them is unique. So we see that indeed G is a group. A is a group with my binary addition of my binary operation of multiplication. So those are fun little groups. And you see that groups actually, they pop up everywhere.